amazing people, karibuni tena to another episode of My Painful Scars. I am your host, Reni Njoroge.
And I'm your host, Sherin Njoroge.
Now on this episode, tuko na mgeni wetu hapa, tutampatia chance ajiintroduce, akona a very touching and emotional story. But before ajiintroduce, we wanna introduce you guys to a very good hardware, iko pale Kubukubu Road, inaitwa Pelaziz Hardware. Here kwa hii hardware, you get all your plumbing solution. Any worries, tuko nazo za plumbing, they got you covered. So we have their numbers here on the screen, you can contact them, na watakushikisha vizuri.
Mm-hmm. So, boss, sasa?
Ah, poa, poa.
Utakupatia chance ujiintroduce.
Okay, so my name is Jalibaki. I'm an upcoming Kenyan artist. Nafanya different types of music. Nafanya dancehall, nafanya afro, nafanya reggae. So I just like fuse the music and just create a sound. Mm-hmm. Rock, pia, as in different influences. Mm-hmm. So they can create... probably I would say the sound that I would like. So I'm born in Kenya, grew up in Kenya, and nilisomea Kenya until form four. Yep. And so after form four I was here around in Kenya. It's kwa napenda Kenya nafanya, you know. Oh. So I felt that nilikuwa nataka something more because I was not doing at the moment what like my heart wants. Mm-hmm. I was not doing like what I have passion in. So Nika decided to try and move. I moved to Nairobi to get the already necessary documents for me to go out outside the country, you know. Mm-hmm. So Nikaenda nikapata the passport, nikapata the visa. It was a process, a very long one, because at the moment I was staying in Meru. Mm-hmm. So I'll go from Meru to Nairobi, maybe for the day, in the evening come back to Meru, or maybe sleep in Nairobi and come back to Meru the following day. Mm-hmm. And the process was good. I was lucky enough to put out the required documents, and I moved, decided to move. So time I figured Ikuja, I just like through the help of my dad and my mom. Mm-hmm. At the moment, because I think I had prepared everything. It was in course. Kila kitu ilikuwa ready. So hata wakiniachilia niende, they were seeing like I'm gonna go do something constructive.
Unajua ilikuwa unaweza kumbuka ni which year hivi?
That was 2018. Yeah, that was 2018 October is when I moved. Yes.
Oh, kidogo ni kukatize. Maybe you can tell us kidogo before tufike hapo. Maybe you can tell us, unaweza tuambia tujue your family, pale penye umetoka. Ulikuwa na siblings wengine, alafu what made you, your life ya hiyo time ilikuwa inakaaje? What made you kufikiria utoke Kenya, maybe uende place ingine? Nimesikia kusema kuhusu, you didn't love what you're doing, you wanted to do your passion.
Yes, yes.
So unaweza tueleza, maybe life ilikuwaje hiyo time?
So I was born in a, I would say a humble family. My dad was a serviceman in the army before he grew with the ranks, of course. And my mom was just a teacher, primary teacher, primary school teacher. So life was just simple. I have three siblings. We are four. So I have two sisters and one brother, Moses Nyaga. And
Moses Nyaga ni ule mmoja tunajua.
The Wairomeda guy. So I decided to move because, in fact, since when I was young, sijaikuwa mtu wa kukaa home. I've been always outside. Even before niende shule, by then, nimekuwa tu ule msi alikuwa nakaa nje. Naitwa na yeye anakuja kutafuta nikuje kukula. As in, sijaipenda kukaa home, you know. I was just outside doing something. I like sports a lot. I've been a sports guy since when I was young too, so niko huko nje kimbia, just doing something, you know. So that is what also I think led to that desire to go for more when I grew up now to an adult, because hata shule yenyewe sijaisomea karibu, maybe nikuwa primary even nisomea hapa Embu kidogo kidogo, nika move from now where I was kind of Nairobi high school. Then after nimemaliza nikaenda Meru, nilikuwa nataka kuenroll some business course nilikuwa nimeadvisiwa nifanye at Meru Kiambu University. But my heart was not there.
No, it wasn't there.
Nilikuwa na feeling.
You were advised by your parents.
Yeah. Uh-huh. My parents and the friends, you know, like the people close to me. It was like I would say an influence for me to go do that. But sikuwa na dai. Mimi mwenyewe nilikuwa najua sikuwa nataka. And then this now character yangu ya kuwa niko a little bit shy, so nakubali ngiambiwa tufanye hivyo, nakubali because of the situation, but deep in my heart najua hapana, sitaki. So I had to go first and also meditate on it, you know, nifikirie nione nataka nini really like. And at that point when nilifika 2018, I was like, my heart was like settled. I was sure as nistaki kukua hapa, sitaki kufanya business. I want to go do something that involves music and sports. So I decided to combine both of them, music and sports. Ndiyo sasa nione kwenye itani lead as in which one will go for, because how I know myself, I can do both, you know. So ndo nikamua kutoka. Yes, in 2018 October, after all the process and stuff, nikatoka.
Ukatoka, unaweza tuambia maybe uliamua kutoka ukaenda Africa, ulikuwa within Africa ama ulienda outside country?
Okay, nilitoka immediately, na nilitoka immediately, I went direct to Italy. Nilipitia Qatar, nikakaa siku kadhaa, ndo nikaenda Italy. Yeah, so I was, my visa was heading to Italy, you know, so Qatar ilikuwa tu nimekaa huko tu kubangaiza kidogo kidogo.
Na wazazi sasa, were they supporting ama?
Okay, at the beginning, first of all, because wazazi nilikuwa nimewaambia naenda kusoma. And in fact, I had applied a school for it to look like real. As in, hii ilikuwa ni kama plan ilikuwa nimeamua.
So like I have to go a school in Italy.
Yes, because my dad, kitu ya kwanza, ange ni allow kwenda tu hivyo. My dad wanted me to study, become an engineer, of which I work, like hiyo ndiyo nini yangu, because ni ile sijaipata chance ya kusoma engineering, sound engineering, but I would like to do sound engineering, you know. So my dad already from the beginning, alikuwa anataka niende nifanye hiyo, ni something big, you know. So I had to now bring him to where he wants. Unaona, lazima nitumie masomo. Yes, because ingekuwa ni kitu kingine
angekubali.
It was very difficult. So he because I nilikuwa nimemwambia hivi since before nimalize form 4, nilikuwa namwambia I wanted to do something not nje but hapa Kenya. So alikuwa ameanza kujipanga. So when I applied for this school, na in fact later ikakuja, the school is called Politecnico di Torino. Is in Italy. So when I applied for this school, the letter came for the not admission, but it was like an exam, a test, you know. I had to go do a test, and then after the test, now I get the study visa. So I used it and I convinced my parents with it. But yeah, in my heart, that was not it.
So ina maanisha ndio uweze kwenda Italy. Does that mean that the school approved
Yes, they approved my attachment. So I'm going to find an exam. So I go do the exam, and then after the exam, if I pass, they will extend my visa. If I don't, maybe I should come back and retry again maybe the following semester. Yes. So this one, iliviana poa kabisa. I was like very lucky to get everything that I needed, the visa, the passport, and the requirement, because to get a visa, lazima kuambia unaenda kufanya nini, lazima kuwa na proof what you're going to do. And venye nilikuwa so young, kuna venye ilikuwa ngumu sana kunipitisha. So the school played its part because
it was very crucial.
I was turning 19 that 2018 November. So in the end of October, I was like a month turning 19.
So maybe
maybe weeks, I think.
So maybe you can tell our viewers, I'm sure kuna watu huko nje wanaweza taka kwenda maybe outside countries. I'm sure you were excited sana when you lifika huko. How was life? Na maybe kweli ili happened when you ulikuwa unatarajia ama what happened?
Okay, for me, first of all, I don't have so much expectation before something happens. I always first like have the type of people like nataka kufanya kitu, nasema okay, I will do it and then I will see what happens if I do it. like curiosity, you know.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So nikienda ni of course when nilifika when you later ilikuja I was excited. This has worked. My mm-hmm. plan has worked. Mm-hmm. And when you pia nilitoka huko nikaenda nikafika I was very excited that mm-hmm. the plan has worked. So I went to the straight to school where I was going to go do the exam. Nikuwa natudo kiasi kiasi, so there was a rental place where I would stay now for the period. The exam ilikuwa I think 2 weeks.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So in these 2 weeks I had a place because everything it will make it was in nimepanga and it was planned everything.
Uh-huh.
And so yeah, nikaenda, I was very excited, nimefika, kila kitu ima work, I'm out of Kenya, venye nilikuwa nataka. I'm in school now, nangoja exam and everything was cool.
Uh-huh.
But tukaanza kufanya exams, hati yangu ikaanza kurudi pale pale, naambia hapana, wewe si wa huku. Ni sawa umekuja lakini kuna venye hii reason yako ile honest kabisa unajua si. So I just said okay, I will do it, whatever venye itakuja itakuja. So nikaifanya and in the end physics just with I think I was 3 points because huko na accounting na I think up to 30 something 30 yeah. Nearly disqualified with by physics only physics by 3 points.
Three points.
Zingine ulipita. So wakani offer a possibility to kufanya another course, you know, with what I had passed, you know, maybe to change the stuff and maybe redo.
In the beginning, we'll kuna tafuta engineering, yes, software engineering, yes, and yes, the sounds.
Yeah, the sound engineering.
Mm-hmm.
So now I just like. Can you offer now another course, stuff in a business, business in the IT, something like that. The same course that I was doing here in
Kenya.
I had started doing in Kenya, those few months that I was there. So I didn't feel like I would do it because if they gave me that, the second chance now, if I exam in Guinea at that course, that's nikakata. So nikasema, I will know what to do. And so my time at the place when I live ikaisha, my money ikaisha, siezi piga, siezi, as in venye najua, the economy there is very high, you know, si kama Kenya, ama Africa, tuseme, because the money system venye iko, Europe, America, their currency is higher than in Africa, you know. So of course, nikituma, huko nikiwana so, huko nikama dhao.
Mtu wako huko anaweza benefit.
Yes.
If so anapata do from high,
if anapata do from there, then ni kutuma do from Africa to there is expensive. Atakana ni mtu wakona pesa haji. Of course, maybe kama wana pesa haji feel, but someone who is like maybe on a normal level, you feel it. So I had to find a solution myself. So yeah, I went in the streets of Italy in a city called Como. The south is, you know, the north of Italy. So there, if nikapatana na other people from Africa, the immigrants who also are there, maybe some are running from serious stuff, maybe wars, like maybe when you go to Sudan or stuff, or maybe you go to like a country in the west, but they're running from something. So these are serious people seeking for asylum, like people were troubled in their countries. So nilipatana these guys, and this guy was from Guinea. And nikapatana, and tukapatana, tukaongea, nikamchapia venye niko, randa ni gani, nafanya nini huko, nikamwambia the whole stuff. And that time I was like really tiny, you know, nilikuwa sayala nende, nasikia nilikuwa kidogo mkubwa, because nilikuwa tiny, sikuwa na ndevu hata, I was like a kid, you know, I was like, but the guys there, the Italians walikuwa wanasema I'm like 15 years old, you know.
You looked younger than your age.
I looked like 15 years old.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so pia ile perception, huu jamaa unajua he was a mature guy, maybe 30 something years. So pia alini approach, ndio alioni kama kuna venye I'm being troubled something. So nikamweleza the situation, akanionyesha mahali nitaenda to do what, to seek help. So now he took me to a place, the priest, the priest wanaganga, Dons. Naitanga uko Don. So the guy was called Mwanela. He was like he had built like a community for the now the young people who are accompanied in Europe. So huko kuna miners wengi nini. So what I did, I went there and yeah, age yangu pia ilibidi ni kidogo. Ilibidi tu ndio survive, unaona?
Yeah.
Nikaficha hadi passport nilificha. Mm-hmm. So I
Ulisema ulikuwa old.
Yes, I said I was 60.
Na huko kwa hiyo place walikuwa na kaa, the priest, were you the only one mwenye ulikuwa na sidua masafu, kulikuwa na
wengine? There were like miners. other very many people like from different countries, others from South America, like Cuba, like the Latinos, you know, others from Asia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, those countries. There were even, I think, I don't know if it was that place, yeah, there were two Italians in that place too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, young Italians who maybe I think their parents had some problems. So it's called comunità, you know. It's like a community, you know, of these guys.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I went there. It was very, I think I was welcomed very well. Mm-hmm. Everything is cool. And they said they will help me out and everything. So now we started the process now of the documents to get, because at that time my visa had expired. Mm. I am illegal in that country.
Mm.
Yes. So I cannot work, I cannot go to school, I cannot do nothing because I don't have any document. When you go to look for work, you ask for documents. Mm-hmm. Unless maybe you're doing, unafanya kazi, it was vibarua. I think I'm narrow. Lavoro in nero.
Lavoro in nero.
Yeah. So I think I had to go through the process of the document. So we started, and it was a long process because remember nilidanganya for me to survive because I had to do it. You know, sometimes manze life because ata wamewapoka. Kama ni unaona hata Biblia yenyewe kuna mali these prophets kuna mali ilibidi wadanganye ndio waje kitu fulani. Yes, if you read the Bible well you see it. So for me I think I just had to leave the course to take itself, you know.
This time you go through all these troubles. Wazazi walikuwa wanajua?
Yeah, I was telling my parents that I'm okay. Sijaambia my parents iko poa.
Na walikuwa wanajua since ulikuita ile kazi ulikuwa not kazi ile study ulikuwa unafanya business in IT. So did they know ulikuwa umeachana na hiyo kazi?
Yes, they knew and nilikuwa nimeachana university and I was like sweetening this thing because nilikuwa naambia I found help somewhere, it's very cool, these guys are very friendly. So I was sweetening it at some point, you know.
Okay.
Yes, so
kwa pale naweza kuuliza emotionally how was it draining kuona like wapo umekuja umeanza ku ask for help that is not what was in the plan for you kienda huko, so ilikuwaje emotionally?
Of course emotionally I was a little bit I would say frustrated, yeah, kind of, but pia as in how I am mimi siwezi sema nasemanga heri I don't really give up yani. Si rahisi unipale nimesema nimeachana na na najua poa na nataka kitu from there. So for me, of course I'm a human being, so I have to have the emotion. I have to feel okay, I'm sad, I'm frustrated, unikwaje. But then at the same time I had to say like okay, I wanted this, nilikuwa nataka to come and find what I want. So in the end I just have to find a way.
Okay. Yes. So tukirudi, I want us to go to a short break and tukirudi nataka utueleze saa hii life ya Italy ilikuwa aje venye sasa umetoka kwa hiyo penye ma priest walikuwa naishi kama walikuwa na provide everything. I'll ask you that question. But guys, let's go on a short break, and before we go for the short break nataka niwakumbushe about Pelazi's Hardware pale Kubukubu Road. All your plumbing solutions zitakuwa hapo, all your plumbing worries zitakuwa sorted pale, so visit them, the numbers are on the screen, and utakuwa sorted. So see you after this break.
Welcome to Dunamis Roark, your trusted partner in property management. We provide exceptional service and personalized care to ensure your properties are well maintained and your tenants happy. From regular maintenance and inspections to handling tenant concerns, we've got you covered. Our dedicated team is always available to provide support and solutions, ensuring peace of mind for property owners and residents alike. Choose Duna Misroak for reliable, professional and caring property management services. Contact us today on 0793-309-325 or 0790-245-575.
We have young men that they don't want to appear in the light. They don't want a godly counsel. We are interested in your success. So you must spend time with God and know when Jesus speaks. Ministry is difficult.
Huduma ni ngumu.
Things are tough.
Mambo ni magumu.
Sometimes you don't feel like it.
Wakati mwingine hauhisi vile.
But you don't close.
Angwenwa wende kuongerera madhomo maku. Sukuru wa Management University of Africa mai ava gukuwani ya mwerekera. Mwerire wa September mwako uyo maina intake kwa dhigiresi ya certificate irongo rerwe ni entrepreneurship, ICT, counseling, psychology na sienge nyenge na sionde sie kuambiriri ya mini grade ya D-Train. Wina mean grade ya C brain kana C minus no okorwe ugeka diploma courses ta diploma in management and leadership, diploma in supply chain management, wavamue na diploma in international relations and diplomacy. Na twa ogwo tu maina ginya kodi shia undergraduate programs ta iria niyo bachelor courses na kiria urende kana nuwa mean grade ya C plus wana kana ukurwe na diploma kuma sukuru wesikene. Kodhi ishia masters ititigetwe na vuva amune tondo maina masters in business administration, masters of arts in development studies, masters in management leadership, wana ongienda gweka PhD courses, maina kodhi ta PhD in management and leadership, wava mwena PhD in business administration. Duka riganirwe mai wana professional courses takas Neb, French, Nek, na sienge, nyenge kwa guondu kegwe wina dhina aditondo maina online classes na physical classes. Wimwe na wa Mount Kenya no wiki kodhisi yetu asukurure wa Achievers College Embu. Nwa umakore main campus, Kisaju Off, Kitengera Road, Kajiado Road, Nairobi Campus, Bellevue, South Sea, Popo Road of Mombasa Road. Kana umavorele dimokure namba, kivogo mugwanja, imwe idhano, idhathatu igere, imwe kivogo idhano, idhatu kana niyo 0715621053. Email yao niyo rodieki@mua.ac.ke. Kana umakinyire website ili yao ili niyo www.mua.ac.ke. The Management University of Africa, enabling future, impacting progress.
Welcome to Minor Highway and Highway Court Hotel, where comfort meets convenience. We pride ourselves in offering top-notch conference facilities, perfect for your business meetings, seminars, and events. Our state-of-the-art conference rooms are equipped to cater for all your professional needs. Mm-hmm. Enjoy a refreshing hot shower in our self-contained rooms, each featuring modern amenities and a comfortable setup. For your convenience, we offer lift lodging facilities, making access to all floors easy and hassle-free. Indulge in our delicious snacks and savor the flavors of fresh seasonal fruits and vegetables. Quench your thirst with our freshly squeezed juices made to order for your enjoyment. Book with us today. Call 0722-827-700 or 0722-831-226.
Welcome guys to our second part ya history ya Jalibaki, and it's very inspiring. But before we continue, nataka niwakumbushe about Pelazi's Hardware. Iko hapa Kumbukumbu Highway, just along the highway, and anything you want, every plumbing material, every service, pipes, anything you need, wakall kwa hizi numbers ziko hapa chini ya screen and they will get you sorted. Mm-hmm. So guys, karibuni tena. So we are here with our guest Jalibaki, and tulikuwa tumefika pale ulikuwa umesema umekuwa kwa ile nyumba ya mapriest, umesema zinaitwa dorms.
No, the priests are called dorms. The place is called comunità.
Comunità, meaning community. So nilikuwa atakuuliza huko, were they providing everything that you need, kulala, chakula?
Of course, when you're a minor, you're protected, you know, even the law there protects the minors. So kila kitu ilikuwa provided. You have three meals a day. You even wake up maybe in the morning to go do some cleaning of the compound, and they pay you maybe 10 euros. You know, so maybe you can, when you go outside with your friends, you can go buy some stuff, like simple stuff, you know. So yeah, at the place, the welcome in the first place was like very, like, very nice. I was a minor, you know, for them. So it was very, very cool, you know. There's food, there's everything. The only thing that maybe is not there is maybe your, I don't know, you are in another country, so I mean, there is already that freedom already gone, you know.
Now, are you able to communicate with your parents from there?
Yes.
Constant communication?
Constant, nilikuwa napigia the time, you know, si sana, so tulikuwa tunaongea na simu, on WhatsApp, because the video calls, WhatsApp, you know, smartphones. That's how we used to talk. Not really every day, but we're gonna make sure maybe in a week, maybe three times.
Okay. Na sasa nikuulize, kuna swali najua viewers wanajiuliza pale. Italy is a place where they don't speak English sana. So ulikuwa na communicate nao?
Yeah, in fact, it was difficult at the beginning, but I had to learn the language real quick. And so at the beginning, kulikuwa na some, the people now, they know it's a community, it's a community, so there are people from different countries. So kulikuwa na the place kulikuwa only with, I think there was one guy, he was 16 years old, alikuwa from Pakistan, I think Pakistan, something like that, alikuwa naongea English. So this guy, alikuwa anajaribu translate here to start, as in alikuwa naongea English, I don't know, just not much, not advanced, as in akuwa ile anajua English sana, but alikuwa anajua English to kiasi kiasi. So alikuwa anajaribu kunisaidia saidia, you know. And then, yeah, and then there was the educators, you know, because in the place like that where they're minors, there are also some educators who like monitor them and stuff. So pia alikuwa anaongea English. Ile English ya Italians, wajua Italians wana English ingine. So walikuwa wanasaidia hii idea. But with time I decided to take a step and learn the stuff. So nikachukua tu vitabu tu ile, nakumbuka every time nikiamka in the morning after breakfast, 2 hours nilikuwa nasoma Italian only. in the evening before nilale, 1 hour or 2 hours, nasoma Italian.
Mm-hmm.
So these are I started learning. Mm-hmm. And then nikiwa nje na mabeshte, nikisikia amesema watu, naingia kwa simu, Google Translator, mm-hmm. nasikia amesema wewe chao, na Google hapo chao, naona ni hello. Yeah. So that's how I started learning.
Mm-hmm.
And then my curiosity too, ile curiosity too, yani, ya kujua vitu, mm-hmm. I learned it fast, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I think 6-7 months I was already speaking Italian,
mm-hmm.
on a level where I could even work.
Oh, so 6-7 months kumaanisha hapa hivi ulika for a while ukiwa Italy, ulikuwa miaka ngapi? Ulika miaka ngapi?
In Italy I stayed for 5 years.
Oh.
Yes.
And so you can tell us maybe after ukiwa unaishi tu huko,
mm-hmm.
What happened? Kuliendelea aje tena ukajipata umetoka huko?
Yeah, so nilitoka huko because of the document stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I like the situation pushed me in the end.
Mm-hmm.
Ikabidi I just like say the truth, I was not a minor, nikatoa mm-hmm. pia documents zangu, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So ilibidi wanipeleke to another place,
mm-hmm.
the same community, but maybe where people are a little bit older, 19 years, 20,
mm-hmm.
21 maximum, I think, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And this place, nikienda hii place, by the way, sikuwa bado nimetoa the documents, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Bado ilikuwa tuile, like, it's like a waiting period.
Mm-hmm.
So venye nilikuwa huko, nikakaka, going on with the classes, going on with doing stuff, because I started even going for like trainings of
mm-hmm.
other money works, you know. Nikapata mabishte wengi wazae huko wanafanya maybe kazi za mjengo, kazi za gardening, kazi za timber cutting. So when I was taken out to this second place where you find there are people, some bigger people who can, maybe adults, you know, from 18 years and up to 22 really, where you can now work. So hapo nilianza kuintroduce to now this stuff, because they would say, okay, here you will not stay much because you're an adult, so you have to start now having something with a jitegemea.
Mm-hmm.
So nilikuwa nasoma, sometimes naenda kufanya hii stuff. Nifanya paka matrainings ya kurupezi mabikes, the race bikes.
Mm-hmm.
There's a guy, alikuwa natuwa Mauro, I think, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We went with him, alinchukua, so alikuwa nila kunitrain kurupezi bike. So maybe in times ya races, zikianza, maybe can go now get a job. Maybe there's a leap for the day, because then they pay for the hours. You know,
mm-hmm.
so I started these trainings. Alafu pap, ikabili in the end situation wenye lifika, nitoe my documents.
Mm-hmm.
So nikatoa.
Na mbona walikuwa nataka hizi documents? To verify tu ama?
To verify, and also if you have to move now to get a permit of stay in that country, sasa ukuwe nuko legal, lazima ukuwe na either the birth certificate of your country,
mm-hmm.
or a passport,
mm-hmm.
or an ID of your country,
mm-hmm.
now as a reference.
Oh.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little bit in our party too, because in the end,
mm-hmm.
if I wouldn't, hata hii training yote nafanya ni bure, just easy pata job.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So yep, I just like give them,
mm-hmm.
and yeah, tukaendelea. Nikatolewa sasa hapo, nikapelekwa sasa now the final part now.
Mm-hmm.
And this final part, this was really like this was crazy, because
mm-hmm.
he plays. Ilikuwa nao ya the adults, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Unapata mtu akona miaka, mmoja akona 40, mwingine akona 50, mwingine akona 25, mwingine 35.
Mm-hmm.
People from different countries, Ghana, Guinea. I have a lot of friends from Guinea-Bissau,
mm-hmm.
Senegal.
Menye mwipata na wote
huko. Yes, that place. Because
mm-hmm.
it was like, that place was a place, ilikuwa, ni kama komunita pia, but hiyo ilikuwa inaitwa parokia, it's like a parish.
Oh, parokia.
Yeah,
parokia.
It was like a parish, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So your place, sikama community, sikama community, sasa.
Mm-hmm.
That's like another level, you know.
It's tough, ama?
Yeah, it's really tough. Because kitu ya kwanza, heating za hizo nyumba hakuna. So najua Italy ni Europe.
Mm-hmm.
So winter, degrees inakala negative 2, negative 3,
mm-hmm.
0.
Very cold. Then.
So hakuna hizo nini.
Mm-hmm.
So kumbukata tutuko tunawasha moto hapo na kuni.
Mm-hmm.
Tunaota moto, unaipreserve, unajifunike hizi. So, yeah, the place was crazy, because now there it's adults there.
Mm-hmm.
Chakula, tuliko tunakula inye na bagi kwa hoteli.
Mm-hmm.
As in, you can buy hoteli, this is done.
Mm-hmm.
You lazima angeshugulika, and anazichugua tunajini. But now, you know, here, you're also an adult, so you're also working.
Mm-hmm.
This guy also, that place, the don, gives people, alikuwa, kuna mali alikuwa anaenda kukata mbao, kukichaka kubwa.
Mm-hmm.
So that place alikuwa na tupeleka wengi sana kukata mbao, kuzi transport kwa kimlima fulani hapo.
Mm-hmm.
Kwa ni kama ukienda mbele unaweza mlima.
Yeah,
now the place looks like that now.
Mm-hmm.
you know, somehow. Mm. And yeah, so that place is an adult life.
Oh, pale, maybe naweza kuuliza hapa kwa hii ingine ulikuwa umesema the relationship between people huko ilikuwa mzuri sana, uli welcomewa vizuri. Mm-hmm. Sasa venye uliingia kwa hii ingine parish, mm-hmm, ilikuwa ilikuaje? People walikuwa welcome pamoja na wewe kwa tu maisha yako?
Of course the welcome is okay because, mm-hmm, you know, they are my fellow Africans. They are, mm-hmm, the people with the same, like almost the same situation.
Mm-hmm.
We are migrants here, we are refugees here, we are seeking for a better life, mm-hmm, seeking documents for asylum. Now, by the way, wase wengi wanyana kuangapo, they are the older people without documents,
mm-hmm,
you know, because even in that country without document, ata nyumba wezi chukua, mm-hmm, because the landlord, mm-hmm, atakuliza documents kichukua nyumba.
Mm-hmm.
So it's that complicated. So the place, this donor alikuwa ameprovide, just a simple structure,
mm-hmm,
ku hold these people as they wait for the response from the government for, mm-hmm, the documents.
Mm-hmm.
So zonona mimi sasa nimetoa passport,
mm-hmm,
I have to get now the permit of stay. Mm-hmm. I'm not a minor, I'm an adult. Mm-hmm. I have to go there now with the life,
mm-hmm,
fanya nini. So the place was crazy because it's for adults. So the, mm-hmm, don doesn't teach you as a kid, he teaches you as an adult.
Mm-hmm.
You know, na si ati uko hapo unamlipa hata rent.
Mm-hmm.
Uko hapo anajaribu kusaidia, mm-hmm, na pia kuna ile character, yeah, cheki wewe ni mtu mzima, mko hapa anajaribu kusaidia, so wacha ufaa. Yeah. So yeah, ilikuwa tough, very tough, because we would go work and then I was also playing football at that time. So nilikuwa nakumbuka after job, nilikuwa na kafiri kalikuwa hapo hivyo nje. So if I'm as like I wanted to keep myself busy because I felt like my mind was going like too fast, you know, things were going too fast for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to keep myself with the staff, you know,
mm-hmm,
kama siko job na kuja naenda kuchukua board na kucheza na jamaa wengine because we were big people, we were even making tournaments, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
So inamaanisha vile ile mind ulikuwa nayo ya kupursue your music and sports,
mm-hmm,
inamaanisha you were not really able kuifikia
at that moment. Mm-hmm. I was really still pushing because kitu ya kwanza, those places in Europe, if, mm-hmm, they see a talent, they really like, ni rahisi kukua spotted na kukua scouted.
Mm-hmm.
So I was really pushing hard in all these things.
Mm-hmm.
At the time sikuwa na access musical stuff and stuff, mm-hmm, but football nilikuwa nayo. So music, I was only my headphones, the book and the instrumentals on then YouTube,
mm-hmm,
on 2BD, you know.
Yeah.
That at the moment music nilikuwa naifanya hivyo, but now football kulikuwa na field,
mm-hmm,
because football is a big culture in Italy, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we all know Serie A stuff, you know.
Yes.
So it's a big culture.
Mm-hmm.
So football, there are fields everywhere in Europe. Good fields, even you might find a field small, but it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
So I was keep myself busy. Kama siko job, and pia nasoma kidogo. There were some volunteers, older women in Italy who were coming to teach now people English, and they're not English, Italian in this place.
Mm-hmm.
Because unapata at that place, kuna mtu amekuja kwa 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
Ameingia last month, ajui anything, ajui Italian, ajui nini.
Mm-hmm.
Amekuwa mbibi anafanya kazi ya, maybe, plumbing in his country.
Mm-hmm.
Kumeharibika, maybe mekua na wars and stuff, amebidi ya kuja. So that guy is like, umurudisha zero na vile kwa ameji-establish.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, this guy is also, pia kulan, maybe unapata ni ngumu, so they had to be taken like slowly.
Mm-hmm.
So the place, yes, in terms of with people and stuff, ilikuwa poa, but now the situation, we all knew how it was, so you had to just like swallow it and
so
have it how it is,
yeah,
and try to make your way out.
Mm.
You know, everyone try to make your way out.
Mm.
Tuseme pale, we were together, but in your mind, it's like you guys are in a cage somewhere, and ni kila mtu ajaribu find a way out. Ukiweza usaidie mtu bishte yako bro, is how. Because later, we moved to a house,
mm-hmm,
and nilipata document, nikaanza kufanya ka job kwa hoteli, kuosha masahani,
mm-hmm,
yeah. Ni kuita kiasi kitu kidogo, you know.
So saizo unatumia sasa hizi documents zako za
yeah, na after nimepata sasa because when I nitoa passport,
I
was even lucky because there was a lady there, she was called Georgia, she really helped me a lot kupata documents, you know, ali push sana, ali stand me alafu,
mm-hmm,
Because I was also like really willing to move, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Language in Liliana Nikalanaraka, stuff ni kwa chap chap kwa mambo. So these guys pia wakaona this guy kuna venye he deserve. Jwana nakumbuka nikienda now because you go for something called commission, commissione. Mm-hmm. It's a commission, you know. You have to speak to a jury.
Mm-hmm.
To tell them why you came out of your country, why you don't want to go back,
mm-hmm.
and why you shouldn't give you documents.
Mm-hmm.
And nakumbuka niliongea Italian in that thing. Nililetewa translator aliongea vitu hata zifika 10. I speak Italian. So these guys they were even impressed maybe with me.
Mm-hmm.
So wakanipatia documents, akasema, I think we can trust you. You can survive here.
Mm-hmm.
Juu, ukienda majuu, akulizangi kwenye metoka, atakuliza unafanya nini.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are you bringing here?
Yeah, benefit, any value? What are benefit at?
Yes, even though majuu, unafanya kazi. So venye walicheki kuna venye mimi nachangamka nini alafu pia nilikuwa nimesoma unaona nimefika hadi uni nilikuwa nimeshaanza uni huko hivi so kuna venye
the academic academics zako walikuwa wanaona uko smart
yes and also how I'm doing stuff nchama ingia huko 7 months na ungeita then it's not easy so kuna venye walikuwa convinced so kanipa the documents I moved now started a life joined some local teams there and I if hata ukienda huko ukiuliza walikuwa wananiita this guy Cavallo. Cavallo is like a horse, you know. Yeah, Cavallone because I was small. So Cavallo is a horse, Cavallone is a small horse. So now they're calling me Cavallone because of like how I was playing football because like running, we not getting tired, fast, stamina, all this stuff, you know. So I started well, so I would play football when I get back home, music. Right then. If I'm not working, I would go maybe work after work. I come go for football in the evening for maybe 2 hours. After that, go 1 hour session with music, then sleep. That was the routine.
So there were no consequences for you lying about your age?
At the beginning, there were because it was like really difficult to convince these people. It's like kuambia pole nini. I would say also luck was on my side pia. Juu kuna venye in the end your story ilipotelea tu hivyo.
Nikapata
documents. It was juu hata venye nilikuja na to this last place the parish. Nilikumbuka nikiingia this don and said ani wale wajanja they call them furbo you know something
smart.
Someone who is like cunning smart or maybe someone who yani mtu si rahisi yani maybe mtu anaweza I don't know how to say yani someone who maybe smart yani kitu kali furbo ina wacha smart so when I came the first ali alikuwa anasema furbo so I mean that thing pia kuna venye the my interaction with these people pia ili change their perception maybe they ilikuwa like okay the guy alikuwa in a situation so he had to escape the situation because all the people wenye anakuwa kwa hiyo place the immigrants they are in the situation so already these guys already have that perception because we're in a situation, of course. Na mimi pia nyenye ni situation ilikuwa. Kuna venye ilikuwa noma. So I had to. So in the end, they had to understand me, you know, and wakanipatia the documents. But, lazima usurvive huko kuwa.
Sasa hapo ulipata job ya hoteli. After that, kulienda aje?
Nikapata job ya hoteli. I started doing. It was like really tough because unapata nyumba, unapata, unalipwa yes, poa. But unapata the house is expensive, you know, the bills there are expensive food, kununua nyumba nini. So unalipopoa 8 hours every day uko job, unarudi home, kuna pia nini zingine. Because I'm also trying to venture now into what I wanted. So niko job, nikirudi nangangana kwa football, which is a very physical game. But niko kwa music, like it was like really difficult to like balance these things. So ikafika time nikaachana hata na job kidogo.
Focus na hizi music plus sports.
Nikuwa sana tudo nimesave kidogo. Nikarudi tena job. And then ikafika period I started like it's like giving up on football. Hiyo ni after by the As a matter of fact, 2019, kienda kuisha, talking about 2020,
mm-hmm.
I was scouted by a semi-professional club called Perugia. So nigeenda kwa academy yao. But then my dad had to now pay the learning fees. So akaniambia, okay, this time hata umekuwa huko, umekuwa kizinini, so I can maybe try to help you with this because it looks something constructive. You pia aliongea na managers of the club. Like it was something like, yes, this was now something like serious. I was like, my life was changing, you know, completely. So nikaingia kwa the academy, I was training every day. This time nilikuwa tu naenda weekendi to a friend of mine, alikuwa anaitwa sikumbukizini yake, but this guy had a farm, shamba ya olives, this olive oil.
Olive trees.
So now on the weekend alikuwa ananikujia na gari, tunaenda huko tuna harvest. After the match now, because matches ilikuwa weekend, so nikitoka match naenda ku harvest the olives. Napata tutoto mfuko mzai, meantime anachangamkia stories za kusoma kwa the academy. Mimi na mimi nachangamkia mfuko. And then now this time the academy iko pia imenipatia kakeja mali na ka, and I was staying with other players. It was a good experience. So at least this time niliona manzi kitu inaanza kuwa real. I mean an academy niko poa nini.
Kitu ulikuwa unataka kufanya.
Yes, so this time stuff was a little bit easier. Takaniwa nimeanza ku give up. I had started using some substances.
Drugs.
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Because in that situation, kwanza nikuwa kwa hii parish. I was abusing some stuff.
Ulikuwa unachukulia pia as an escape to the issues and
yes. Yes, of course, because this place, I would say even the guys that I was with, as you were saying, nilikuwa nakaa nao in that place. All were using something. All. Hakuna mtu hata mmoja kwa dunia. You know, except some guy from Pakistan, very quiet guy. I think he had some health issues, so alikuwa ametulia tu.
Haikuwa restricted huko ama mlikuwa mnaficha tu?
Yeah, it was restricted because you would hear they don't tell you I don't want no drugs here. So hata si kuficha. In the end pia don and as well, because sometimes we were smoking it in there, you know.
Atajua tu.
As in, si atajua, anajua already, so as in, the situation iko hivyo. Umekaa na wasio kwa hii situation, you even understand them, because some of them use that thing, because unapata mtu maybe ame-escape, maybe a war in his country, maybe mamake ame-daddy, babake ame-daddy, siblings, wame, yeah, ni survivor. Na many of those guys wanapitia the sea. The ocean, yeah, to come to Europe, you know, they don't even use the airplane. So ule mse kuna venye is very disturbed, you know. So pia madons, they like really understand it, you know.
Maybe I can ask you now, how vile ulijipata je umerudi tena Kenya and ukaachana sana music ama uliendelea kabisa kuipa?
So now academy ilienda ikaisha because I got a very bad injury. In fact, just on the verge of getting signed by a club. Nikapata hip injury, yani nini from the hip, upper back, kwa magoti. Yeah, I was playing. And so it became expensive now to start doing the physiotherapy stuff. Jara nilikuwa nimeanza nini. Unajua alafu football is still a business, you know. So the player, the coach, the team wanataka something that is moving. Na si ati pale already minister ati naweza kuwa niko na mimi madaktari wangu personally. The moment I was starting, promising, yes, but starting. So ikaisha hivyo juu ya injury, but that really was an eye opener that my life was not heading football. That is what I was not meant for. After that, music ndio ilifungua. After that too, when you do football in Asia, music started now bringing chances. So nitoka academy, nikarudi all the way back to the city that I was first when I came in Italy, Como, because football I was playing in the south, in a city called Perugia. So I went back just to Como now in the north where I was first when I came to Italy. Nikarudi maisha nomo, nikapata kakeja na bishti yangu mwenye tulikuwa naye at the parokia. Tulipata naye tuka communicate tukapata kakeja huko. So we were leaving us there. And so at that moment my head really, like now it's like twice how it was, like it's running really fast because things are very fast. I was like in a very promising area where my heart also was. Sijui nifanye nini, career inisha, injury ndio hiyo sijapona. I am recovering myself now.
Mm-hmm.
Mwara nikienda gym, the last part kuinua kufanya the leg stuff, this stuff is like, ilitoka kwa socket yake kidogo.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like really, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So wenye nilirudi, nikarudi job, nikaanza job, nikapata job kwa hoteli, big hotel, but now, ili kwa job ya kitchen kuosha sahani. It's a very big hotel na kuja tourists from everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So you go there, I was in the kitchen washing the dishes, the sufurias and all this stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I had to do it because at that moment,
mm-hmm.
that was the only thing that was in available because football imesha, music ajaanza kunilipa, sijaanza kurecord music in studio. So
mm-hmm.
I was just like myself with samples in at home.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to start now working with the injury also, recovering. I was going to play a little bit. Alafu nikuwa nenda job na bike.
Mm-hmm.
Kama bike fulani
hapo.
Yeah, yeah. Now with the cash that I had nikidokoma.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So
mm-hmm.
nika bike hapo hivyo. So nikuwa nenda nako job narudi.
Mm-hmm.
So this time nika focus now. Kabisa 100% like on music. Nikitoka jobs kwa naenda kucheza juu hata niko na injury and nafanya music.
Mm-hmm.
So nilikuwa natoka naingia kwa Cube. Akili iko mbali sana so I had to use some substances too then get to music.
Yeah. Now how did you now come back to Kenya?
And then at that moment
mm-hmm.
music nilikuwa na search some labels in Milan. Nikachukuliwa
mm-hmm.
na ka label upcoming kadogo tu.
Mm.
Kana grow.
Based in Italy.
Italy, Milan. Ndio sana nimerudi, nimefanya job miezi kadhaa, music, nini. Nikwata naenda kwa ma street kufanya ma freestyles. Kuna kato mbili nimeweka Instagram by the niko huko yapi. So, kalembo kanichukua. Nilienda, as in this moment, nika record demos kama tatu. After I record demos tatu, in fact, it was like 4 years. That was last year.
Mm-hmm.
That was last year, the beginning of last year. Nikakuja Kenya.
Mm-hmm. 2023.
I came to Kenya with these demos. Zilikuwa moja ilikuwa hip-hop, drill, ilikuwa melodic drill, but ikona hip-hop kiasi, ingine ilikuwa trap soul.
Mm-hmm.
I came to Kenya, nilikuwa pia na Doni Medokoma.
Mm-hmm.
I paid some media stuff. Nikakuja nikafanya kama katua hivi.
Oh, wow. Maybe zineza tuguzia kidogo. About your songs venye unaimba unaweza tumia kamoja.
Okay, for now sasa nime evolve sana.
Mm-hmm.
So hiyo time nilikuwa naanza. So hiyo time nilikuwa just some simple stuff.
Mm-hmm.
For right now there's a song inaitwa Ninaimba Sahi, inaitwa Delight. Inaenda hey yeah, girl, getting in your vibe is on point and your vibe is a killer. Hey yeah, girl, getting in your vibe is on point and your vibe is a killer. Yeah, your fashion one killer, fashion yours killer, your fashion is a killer, girl. So that's what I'm singing right now, Afro stuff, you know.
Yeah.
But that time it was like start at the beginning. So nikakuja nikafanya katua.
Mm-hmm.
Nikienda nikarudi, it was frustrating because I realized it was just the money that moved me. It's not the content that I had. Because haikuwa kwenye nilikuwa nataka. So nikarudi Europe, job tena, frustrations, substances.
Mm-hmm.
Music,
mm-hmm.
that was a life.
Mm-hmm.
Sasa nikaenda nikachukuliwa na Kalebo. Chukuliwa na Kalebo is a small label growing. Nikaenda huko mwezi ya kwanza, first 3 weeks, nikuwa narudi the place nikuwa nafanya job, the city. Huko naenda maybe weekend time, niko off. Naomba off mbia siku kama moja.
Mm-hmm.
Then the following day, najua niko tayari nini ya jioni ya usiku. So sikuja asubuhi na kuja afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
So I was spending time in this label, small, very small label to start, you know. And after like 3 weeks going there, nikaamua sasa niachane na job kabisa in Como and I moved to Milan permanently.
Mm-hmm.
And when I moved to Milan permanently, I was sleeping in studio.
Mm-hmm.
Nikuwa jioni na toa kamatres kadogo na ikuna hapo chini. Ma computer ziko pale, piano ziko hapo, guitar ziko hapo, ka space tuka na gaivi na lala hapo. So I spent like 6 months straight in studio every day.
Mm-hmm.
In studio, music. That place because while they had my songs, they got impressed. When nilienda huko, first day, first song nika record, it was a very good song, and it was radio. Sema, I had a sound on the radio, and the playing well, mommy dancing in the kitchen, I ready for the sound on the radio. So it was like the very first song I recorded in that place.
Yeah.
These guys were like really impressed because it was a label, a growing label, very young.
Mm-hmm.
And so they like, oh, Yeah, he has something, you know, some music culture. Mm-hmm. So they said, okay, we're going to pick him. Mm-hmm. And they picked me. They told me, whatever you want, if you want to sleep here, you can sleep here. Mm-hmm. You want somewhere else, maybe you have to find a small job and pay for the rent somewhere else, you know. So mm-hmm. Well, I stayed there for the first month. Alafu January, nikapata ka job now in a hotel, a small restaurant, yeah, there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This one too, ilikuwa ya waiter plus kuosha masari, watu kaweka sana, tukadao pia kana grow. So here it was like really tough because I was working like 9 hours minimum.
Mm-hmm.
Because nilikuwa pia nataka kalebo nilipe. Because lebo, they wanted me to pay for the learning now to advance my skills, but the production they had done it. Like when you finish production, mm-hmm. I pay for the learning.
Mm-hmm.
That is $10,000 in 2 years. Mm-hmm. That is like 1 million Kenya shillings.